Hello, today we're back at Orange Bricks with Marcos, and yes, I'm finally uploading. It's been like 2 months, thanks to Brick by Brick Mox, who reminded me to upload, because I don't know why, I've just forgot about my YouTube channel. So yeah, today I'm going to be reviewing the Batman Classic TV series Batmobile. This set comes with 345 pieces, it's for ages 7+. The reason why I got this set is mostly just to display with my bigger Batmobile and Batwing, I don't know. But it doesn't just come with this vehicle, it comes with this stand and another minifigure, this Joker. We'll look at the minifigures after, but first, let's take a look at the car. First of all, this vehicle has two seats, which is kind of weird, because there's only one minifigure, or there's two minifigures in the set. One's Batman and one's Joker. Should have came with Robin, so Batman would have a buddy to sit with, since there's two seats. At the front, it has some stud shooters. You can take away stud shooters if you want. And there's this like gold thing at the front. It always falls off. So annoying. In the set, surprisingly, it comes with these things. So if you don't like the stud shooters, you can just put these in. I like the idea of these. Lego should definitely do this way more often. So yeah, you can take the stud shooters off the front here. It's not that easy. I wish the set came with a brick separator so you could take it off. It'd be much easier. But it I do like that the set came with these slopes, because people would always complain about stud shooters. What I don't like though is these big yellow pieces at the front. I'm not sure if they're lights or something, but they're just out of, like, they're not supposed to be here. Like, you have a nice color scheme and then you just have yellow bricks at the front. In the cockpit, or whatever you call it, something must have fell out when I was doing the video. I'm not sure, sorry about that. But stickered control panels, and then you have a telephone here, old school telephone. It is also kind of weird when you're looking from the top. You have an arch on one side and no arch on the other side. Oh, I think I know what I did wrong. I didn't put the steering wheel back enough. I'm sorry about that. The steering wheel was back a stud, but anyway. You might have saw earlier, there is a hood at the back. That's where I kept these. So yeah, you could just put them in there. That's a nice little touch. Comes with 3 bat boomerangs, or officially 2, but there's one extra in the extra pieces. And then you have some exhausts over here. And then you have like wings over here, and another exhaust back there. 2 stickers. I hate lining up 1x1 stickers. They should just have them all printed. If they're 1x1, they should be printed. Just like they're printed on the wheels right here. And then, earlier before I was talking about the stand. You can actually connect the stand, which has information on Batman. And you can connect it. I don't like the stand. It sticks out to, like, it's on top of the ground way too much. But whatever. Some people like it. You can spin it. Always falls off. I don't know why. See, it's fragile. One thing I do like about this set is there's barely any studs. It's all smooth. I'm not a big minifigure fanatic, but I don't know a lot about both of them. So all I can tell you is that the minifigures look good. Nice printing on Joker. Joker also has this weapon. Should have came with Robin, like I was saying before. Batman also has a batarang. He has three of them. And his cape, printing behind the cape. Okay. This reminds me of a 4-plus Batman. By the way, there's also printing on the helmet. Thank you, everyone, for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share below. And comment down below what videos I should do next, because I'm dead of ideas. I have zero ideas. I need to come up with more ideas. Bye.